Saturdays for some action. Late night flex, body on drippin' up sus. Every got a chick on buzz, more than a snack, I'm the main course. Pop it for you when you want it, bend over, I've done it. I know it looks gorgeous, so tempting, tempting. It's a richer, no basic, okay, okay. It's a trophy, you deserve it.
Welcome to the Music Corner, Ammoye. Thank you so much for saying yes and being a part of, you know, my new adventure. You know, Meredy, I always have so much ideas as to how I can chit-chat with artists I like and feel like could have more of themselves out there, more of the music out there, and you came to mind because I've been reaching out to artists I believe should just be out there more. People need to hear your voice, and you are one of those artists for me, right?
Oh, I appreciate that. I appreciate that,
you are welcome. Of course, I have gotten the opportunity to spend time with you, and not only spend time with you, but hear your music, hear your voice, and see how you interact with people and how you perform. Well, my normal probably just get a little taste. But those who may not know who Ammoye is, how would you introduce yourself to a group of strangers?
Well, I'm a light worker, born and raised Jamaican, now living in Canada, so now Canadian citizen, but I'm always Jamaican at heart. And I was raised by my grandparents in the church back home, also Clarendon.
Clarendon girl.
And then so I was singing in the choir back from back home, and then I came here and I joined my mom's church singing in the choir, and decided that I wanted to do, because I've always had the calling of writing and singing my own music, and so I decided to pursue that. And against my family's wishes, but I had to. I call myself the little black sheep of the family, the rebel of the family, because I follow my own path. And I walk to the beat of my own drum. So I've been pursuing music professionally since I made that decision, and I've not looked back. And my music is, I call it the music for the soul, you know?
Yeah, it has, I read a couple articles about you, and, you know, it always says reggae artist, you know, reggae singer Ammoye, and I'm like, you're so much more than that. When I listen to your music, yes, it has it with a reggae in it, but it expands, and it's so much broader than reggae, and it's really not just one genre. I don't think one genre can really, you know,
explain
who you are. So when you're breaking into the music industry, you decide, say, you are gonna be the rebel of the family. You want to sing. You want to write your own music. This is your passion. At what age you realize all this, and what was the exact response of your family?
No, I've always known that I wanted to do music from back home. As soon as I finished high school and came here, I recognized and I was aware that this is an opportunity for me to go for it full force with the resources and the opportunities that I had available to me. So I decided to go for it. My family, they're more academics, and I'm very much so the creative. And even though they have the creative gene too, they all sing, and some of them play instruments, and so they have that gene, but they wanted to go for the more secure professions. And for me, I just felt like I had something to say, and through my music. And so I decided that I actually was going to college here, Seneca College, when I migrated. And while I was studying to be a traveler and to be a flight attendant, because I knew too, I wanted to travel. I knew too that I wanted to travel, you know, trying to please them and just trying to please myself. And but then when I was studying, I realized I'm only doing this to please my family. I'm not happy. I'm not. It's not feeding my soul.
Yeah.
And I made my decision to do my music, and they were upset. You know what I mean? They, you know, the same thing that you can expect from parents to say to you, like, this is not a secure. Mm-hmm. Not everybody makes it in music. It's one in a million that makes it in music, and add all kinds of things.
When they were saying all of this, was there ever a point where you doubted your deserve?
Absolutely, I'm only human, so of course I thought maybe I wonder if they're right, but for some reason there was always something stronger. That voice, there was something inside of me that kept on telling me, no, just keep going, yeah. And then four Juno nominations later, proved exactly. that I made the right decision.
I was about to ask you about that, because I'm always, I have this thing where I'm getting over my fear, even doing this. You would think mm-hmm. that, oh, I know you already, and well, mm-hmm. you know, we know each other, so it's not, yeah. I'm not supposed to be nervous, yeah. I'm not supposed to be afraid, but every time I am, you know, when it doesn't matter who it is I am speaking to.
Doesn't matter.
And
I get that, I can relate to that, because even yeah. when I perform, I've been performing since I was three from yeah. back home, and every time I'm about to go on the stage, I get yeah. nervous, and so I use that, I push that, pushes me, and I she put that into the music, and then as soon as I touch that mic,
it's a totally different
dissipates, yeah.
mm-hmm. You know, just having to believe in yourself, and I think that is what I connect with you. You just being a soul rebel and understanding that you are going to do what you want to do, and you're going to do it to the best of your ability
because what we get.
So just, I don't even think it's proving persons wrong. It's just proving yourself right.
That's exactly
what you're supposed to be.
Exactly.
Yeah.
It's never been about proving the right. Because it's just because I know myself, and I listen to my intuition. I've learned to listen to my intuition and follow my gut instincts. And it's never led me wrong. It's never, even though when it looks like everything is not working out, mm-hmm. something comes around the corner and shows me, girl, you're on. Sometimes I have gotten so frustrated because as a female too, doing the music, being in this lane, there's a lot of challenges.
Yeah.
So I've run into situations where it makes me want to just like throw the towel in. But every time I decide to do that, spirit, God, source, whoever you want to call that higher,
yeah. Yeah, something just happens to
me, exactly. Yeah. Sends me something to encourage me and push me on, and it's the best decision I've ever made, to trust myself.
Yes, that's one of the most important things anybody can do, is trust mm-hmm. themselves. Mm-hmm. Being in the music business for so long, being in the music industry for so long, what are some of your greatest accomplishments since being in this business? Mm-hmm.
I mean, there's a lot of accomplishments, like, you know what I mean? Of course, the four-time Juno nomination is a great one, because the Junos here is like the Grammys in the States. And so that's a great accomplishment for me. But really and truly for me, what gives me the satisfaction of continuing to do it is connecting with people, like-minded people around the world. Yeah. I get to travel and sing to people that understand and relate to my music.
Yeah.
And when they come up to me and tell me that this certain song got them through a certain situation, mm-hmm. that is why I do the music. So those little affirmations for me allows me to know that I'm in the right place, doing the right thing, and doing what I'm supposed to be doing.
Yeah.
Awesome. So I feel like those are the biggest accomplishments for me. Every time somebody comes to me and tells me what the music, how the music influences them and inspires them, and even other younger artists who are coming up, and when they reach out to me and tell me that they saw me doing my thing and it made them feel comfortable enough to go out and do theirs.
That's awesome. Yeah. That's good to know. That's a good vibe. All right. So you have all these accomplishments. You have all these amazing music, but I know that you have a new single out. It is a single. A new mm-hmm. single out. It's called Give It All.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
Right, and I've been playing Give It All since the gimmies. I've been
yes. Big up Adrian Dunsell, he's a producer on that one, so big him up. Yeah,
yes. So I've been playing it. I just want to know the backstory about Give It All.
So funny, I wrote that song during 2012, a long time ago.
Yeah, I wrote that song.
Yeah. And to be honest with you, that's when I started going through my personal spiritual awakening, I call it. Long story short, I developed nodes on my vocal cords. I had to be put on voice. I was recording my album. The intent was to record and my first solo album, because I've done EPs mm-hmm. before up until that point, and then collab albums.
Yes.
And then so this was going to be my first solo album. And then all of a sudden I developed nodes on my vocal cords, and I had to be put on voice rest for a year. I was actually in Jamaica.
Wow.
Because I was there to record with Sly, and I was there to record with Donovan Germain and Mikey Bennett and Natural Eye and all of that.
Some good producers.
But everything was put on pause. The thing that came out of that was the music that came out of me during that time. I recognized that it cannot be just music just to be singing about any and everything. Mm-hmm. That's when my music literally, even though I was always conscious and aware of what I was putting out,
yeah.
it became even more so, how do I say it?
It's almost as if
authentic, more, yeah. yes, it was just more, I was shook, I was in a place where I was comfortable in my own skin. I recognized what I am on this planet, I know fully at that point, during that year, I was able to go within and learn how to meditate and be still and allow spirit to move through me and sing through me and write through me, basically. And the songs that came out was that album was called The Light. And that was really discovering the light within myself and then sharing that with the world. Yeah. And so one of the songs that was written but did make the album was Give It All.
Oh, but it didn't.
Didn't make the album, but during this shutdown and quarantine thingy, coronavirus, pandemic, whatever you want to call it. don't get me started on that. But Adrian Dunsum reached out to me. He lives in the States, a record producer, and he was the one who produced that track. And he was like, Ammoye, it's time. This is the perfect time to release that single.
Mm-hmm.
Perfect time.
Yeah.
Like, you know, hey, yeah, let's put it out. And so here we are talking about that song because it's out. And if you,
yeah.
and you can, wherever you purchase music, you can find that.
You can find it there. Mm-hmm. I know everybody had great plans for 2020. 2020 was my year and everybody's year.
Yes, so exactly.
We were ready to take it on. We had our plans. We saw where, you know, things are going to be better. Things are looking up. And boom, out of nowhere, it just started real strong, as we would say here in Jamaica. 2020 just a move real strong.
Right.
And all of a sudden. Yes.
Pause.
And then this pandemic came along. But before all of this, what were your plans for 2020 musically?
Oh, I was actually right before this all happened. It was for the new album, for the Water. I'm actually writing and recording it right now.
Okay, okay.
It's called Water. Right before this happened, I was in Belize writing for the album. And then as soon as we got back, everything is shut down. And so I've been using the time to just continuously writing, and it's evolved into this. I would call it my best work yet. I can't wait to share it with the world.
Wait to hear it,
because there's so much to write about. There's so much that I'm doing, so much research and discovering and learning, so much.
Yeah,
and I put it into the music. It's been cathartic for me and very therapeutic getting the music out that way and releasing it that way.
Yeah.
So I've made it, the situation work for me,
yeah.
if you will.
It has worked for you.
Yes, and yes. Water is going to tell the stories that needs to be told.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Okay, if you, we have like 5 more minutes.
Yeah.
For persons that are planning to come into the music business, especially female, I'm not going to be the first. we're focusing on female.
Yeah.
For a female right now that wants to enter the music industry, probably already start, you know, and they are more on the conscious side. I almost say conscious, it's not necessarily reggae music only, but they're just conscious of what they're putting out there. Mm-hmm. The music is a bit more positive. And it's not as quote unquote raunchy as what is expected from our community.
Yes, I get it. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. What would be your advice to this female trying to break in and trying to stay authentic all at the same time?
I would say, know who you are. Be strong in the knowing of who you are and what you stand for, so that nobody can sway you one way or the other.
Yeah.
And when you've discovered who you are and what you're representing and how you want to represent yourself, then it shouldn't be easy for people to come and influence you as an artist and what you want to say.
Yeah.
So know who you are, own that, and be unapologetic in expressing that to the world through your music, as well as own your craft. Like, you know what I mean? Make sure that you practice a lot. Find the right people that understand your vision and the direction that you want to go in, and that they can accompany on your path in the right and appropriate ways. And again, trust yourself, trust your intuition, trust yourself. And so that when you're making your decisions, you don't regret if it goes bad or not, because you know that that was where you were at that point. And just keep on moving. Always be resilient, because this industry can be challenging. I'm hoping that after this, the smoke clears out of the situation, that the music industry is going to get really well, a good cleansing,
if you will. I hope so too.
And so that things can be a lot more balanced.
Yes.
You know?
Yes.
In terms of giving females the opportunity to express themselves freely without being censored in all kinds of different ways and being held back because of their gender and who, you know what I mean, any of that. I'm hoping that there will be a good cleansing for the in the music industry and all the industries, actually. But I'm in the music industry, so I'm hoping for that. And I can actually, I'm hopeful that things are going
to
get
better. We have to be.
Yeah, things are going to get better.
Yes.
So yeah, just be confident in who you are and represent yourself accordingly. And trust God. Trust God and make sure that the spirit is a big part of what you're doing.
Yeah,
because
to have some sort of
fear. Yeah, exactly. You need that. I learned that in 2012. That even though I was always spiritual, but I became more aware of how important that was in my life
during
that time, and it's only gotten me, made me stronger, and made my music better.
Yeah,
when I paid attention and make sure that I feed my spirituality as well. Feed myself spiritual food as well. It's a good balance now. I'm in a place of balance, I would say.
Yeah.
So yeah, do that for yourself. Spend time with making sure that you're feeding yourself spiritually, mentally, and physically.
Yeah.
And you should be good.
That's some sound advice. I'll take it for myself too.
Mm-hmm.
Thank you so much. I am
thank
going
you,
to say, you know what I didn't do because I was chatting off my face as usual. I did not play Give It All, so I'm going to play it right now so that the people can hear. Before I play it, though, tell us where we can find you. Like, if people need to know, where am I? They come need to learn some more about this lady. Why do they call her?
So yeah, man. Okay, you can find me anyway. Yes. No, thank you. You can find me on Facebook. My fan page is under Ammoye's Music. On Instagram, it's Ammoye. That's Ammoye. And on Twitter, it's Ammoye's Music. Ammoye's Music. My website is ammoye.com. So that's Ammoye.com. And if you want to send me a note or for bookings or anything like that, it's Ammoye's Music. Ammoye's Music at gmail.com.
Okay.
And the music is everywhere. Anywhere you buy music.
Yeah.
You find Ammoye.
And you're not very hard to find. If they just Google Ammoye,
exactly,
will
exactly
come up.
Exactly.
Full force.
Yeah.
So they don't have to worry about that. Ammoye, thank you so much for being
thank
a part
you,
of the music partner. I am going to play give it all right now. And again, thank you so much. You are allowing me to realize my dream as well, because it is very new. So thank
it's
you.
It's a
so
give
much
and take of energy, exchange of energy.
Yes, man.
Yeah.
It's so important for us as women to support each other.
I agree. Fully.
Really difficult in this business. So thanks again. I can't wait.
Thank you.
Forward at Jamaica again.
Yes, I know. I'm looking forward to it. I was planning to come too this year. I was going to go to Mexico, Jamaica, all of it, and the UK and all of it. But next year.
Yes.
Next year.
And next year will be around real quick. So don't worry.
Exactly. I said the same thing too. Next year is tomorrow. So yes. Exactly.
All right. So thanks again, Jojo. You are most welcome. Here is Give It All by Ammoye.
Another day still going through. I'm just trying to find more.
Thanks again, Ammoye.
Pleasure. Bye.
I'll do whatever it takes.
And that was Ammoye. Oh, Lord, I love Ammoye.